Good morning, students. In the last class, we have discussed defining a member function inside the class and outside the class. Today, we'll discuss a lab program. According to your practical list, it is a sixth lab program. That is, you are write a program to create a class with the data members, principal amount, time, and rate of interest. We need to create a member functions one for to accept the PTR value and compute the simple interest, and finally we need to display the result. So the formula, do you remember? Simple interest equal to P into R whole divided by 100. This is your C++ expression, your mathematical expression. PTR divided by 100. So according to your board mass rule, you need to write that braces first. Otherwise, if you are not put the parenthesis, P into R divided by 100, your division will be applicable only for the R. Okay. So, if you are not adding the parenthesis, only the R value gets divided by 100 first. Then whatever the value it will come, that will be multiplied with P value. That is your principal amount and time. Here, it is not a formula. The formula is P into T into R. Principal amount into time into rate of interest. Whatever you will get the complete amount, that you need to divide it by 100. So you need to apply your Bodmer's rule by adding the parenthesis for the given expression. This is your C++ expression. This is your mathematical expression. This is your wrong way of defining the expression. Did you got the student? So here, if you want to calculate your simple interest as a SI, then what value we need? Principal amount, time, and rate of interest. These three are the input values. So input data is a one function. For that you need to accept PTR value, and here one more function is going to be added, that is your calculation part. That calculation, what we need to add, this formula we need to add in the calculation. Then finally the result will be present in the variable SI that you need to output with the output data. Did you got the student? Yes, we start writing the program. Your program contains only two header files. There is no any mathematical functions here. So you need to write two header files here. What are the header files? Yes. Hash include iostream.h, iostream.h, then hash include conio.h. Your input and output operations will be performed with the iostream.h. Your CLR, SCR and getch library functions will be executed with the header file called conio.h. First class declaration. So class definition. Here we are finding what? Simple interest. So I am taking the class name as simple interest. Simple interest. What is the class name I have taken? The class name is always depending on the program. In the yesterday's class, we have written the student details, hence the class name is student. Here we are finding the simple interest, hence the class name is simple interest. It is a meaningful name given to the class definition. It is an identifier, and this will helps you to identify which program we are writing. Which program we are writing? Finding the simple interest. Then declare the variables under a private or public. Any of the access specifier can be used. Declare the variables under a float because your rate of interest, duration of the time, and your principal amount contains your fractional value. Hence, have we taken the data type as float. What are the variables you require? P for the principal amount, T for the time, R for the rate of interest. What you need to find? Simple interest. These two are input variable. This is your output variable. This we have been declared where? Inside the class. Hence these are data members. These are not a variables now. These are the data members. Then what are the functions you need? As the program mentioned that we need to create a members for accepting the data. Accepting means input the data. Compute means calculation. Then display means output. One function for input data, one function for calculation, other function for output data. In this program, I am using a second method defining outside the class. Member function defining outside the class. Our return type is void. First function name is input data. Second function is calculation. Calculation. So when declaration has to be done inside the class, definition has to be done outside the class. Yes, now I am doing only declaration inside the class. What? Member function declaration inside the class. How many member functions I have done? I have done one for input, one for calculation, one for output. These data members and member functions are enclosed in the class definition. Your class has to be terminate. Now we are defining this member function for outside the class. What is the syntax for that? Return type. What is the return type I have used? Void is the return type. Then what is the class name? Simple interest. Simple interest. And your member identity label. What is that? Scope resolution operator. Then function name input data. Now there is no termination because immediately body of the function gets created. What are the values you need here? Yes. Enter. Principal amount. Principal amount. Then time, that is your duration of the period, and rate of interest. Rate of interest. So these values you need to accept. Otherwise you can write enter PTR values. Scene, accept the value for principal amount in the P, rate of time in the T, rate of interest in the variable R. Did you got the student? Then we'll continue here. Another function I am defining outside. What is that? Calculation. The same syntax. Return type. Void is a return type. Class name. What is the class name? Simple interest is a class name. Simple interest is a class name. Member identity label. That is your scope resolution operator. Scope resolution operator. What is the function name? Calculation. Calculation. Parenthesis. Then what you need to apply? Write the formula. What it was there here? Simple interest equal to P into T into R whole divided by 100. Did you got the students? Then, after finding the calculation, we need to display it in the output function. Output function, return type is void. The function name is output data. This output data is belongs to which class? Simple interest. Yes, after return type, write the class name, simple interest, member identity label, that is your scope resolution operator. Then, output data. Output data. You got it? Then here what you need to output? Just see out simple interest equal to simple interest equal to the value which is present in the SI. Here we have only a single output statement. No need to add the end. And if you add also, it will not affect. Okay, this is your defining a member function outside the class. How we can identify we have defined inside the class or outside the class? This is one of the Viva question. They'll ask that by seeing your lab program, whatever you got in the lab, they will ask in your program whether you have been defined the member function inside the class or outside the class. If the scope resolution operator is there, means it is being defined outside the class. If this one is not there, means then it is a inside the class. Maximum all 16 programs, more than 10-11 programs you have been defined outside the class. One or two programs you have been defined inside the class. If it is outside, scope resolution operator will be there. By seeing the program itself, you can answer for one Viva question. And where you have been created the object. Object is created where? Yes, object is created in the main function. Your main function will start now. Program execution begins with main function. Void mean. Even though a number of lines are there, the program execution begins with void main. Then create a class, CLRSM, you can write it above or when after the object creation. Object is created with the class name. What is the class name? Simple interest. Simple interest. What you need to write? We need to create a object so that I am giving a name as OBJ. So this is one of the Viva question where you have created the object. Just putting a finger on your lab program where you have been created the object, you will get 1 marks. Okay. Otherwise, if you want to tell, object is created with a class name inside the main function. That is a sentence format. OBJ dot invoking a function call. If we are invoking a function using object name, member operator, that is your dot operator, along with the function name. Which function? Member function. Input data, obj dot calculation, obj dot output data, output data. Then getch to get the immediate output after key press. We are using getch. This is your first lab program and it is the most easiest one and it is the first easiest one in your program. Okay, so as in the last class I have told, we are not allowing to copy the program by seeing the textbook in the lab. So first you need to practice this program, then you need to execute. How this program will execute? Cursor will come here for the main function, then it will create the object. Once the object is created, then only memory will be created for this particular class. Then control will invoke the function. Which function? Input data. Control will come here, it will find the declaration and move the control to the definition. With the help of the class name, it can link the data members to the member function so that it will accept the value. And please remember, your principal amount should be more than 1000. More than 1000. Please don't give principal amount is 1 rupee, time is 100 and rate of interest is 2000. This is the examples we have seen in the lab program during the lab exams. Your principal amount is a lump sum amount we are giving for the interest. Interest is always, either it is a 3.5, less than the 5, more than the 2. Your rate of interest should be 2.5 or 2.7, 2.8, 3.5, any value. Below the 5, 5 is the maximum rate of interest you need to give. And the duration, please don't give 100. So 100 years, who will alive? Who knows that who will collect the money? Suppose if they have given 2000 here for one rupee and the rate of interest is 2000. What is the meaning of these values while giving? Please remember, your principal amount, you are giving a lump sum amount for the interest. Lump sum amount for the interest. Duration, please give less than 10. And better to give less than 5. This should be more than 1,000. And give less than 1 lakh. Okay? Your time should be more than 1 and less than 5 years. And your rate of interest more than 2 and less than 5. Please remember this value while giving to the computer. So I have been given here. So 1000 or 10,000 you can give it here. And time I am giving for the 2 years. And the rate of interest I am giving 3.5. Calculate it. 10,000 into 2 into 3.5. That value gets divided by 100. Whatever you will get, that value will be displayed in the output function. So whatever you have been given, that value will be present in the PTR. Then control will come back to the calculation function. Your calculation will be performed over here. So that calculation, whatever you will get the value, this value will be present in the simple interest. That value will be displayed in the output function. You got the student? Did you understood how this program will execute? And did you please remember how to give the value? How to give the value? Thank you, student. This finishes your first lab program explanation. That is your, according to the series, it is 6. Finding the simple interest. We'll continue the session. So in the next program, we'll continue in the next class. That is a little bit lengthier program. Now, do you remember in the 10th class you have been studied a quadratic equation? Yes. Please collect the quadratic equation and please work out that how you need to solve that. In that, what do you mean by discriminant? What is the formula for discriminant? And collect your first year knowledge, recollect your first year knowledge, how to write the square root. How to write the square root. So these are the basic things we require for the next lab program. In the next class, we'll discuss the program number 7. Find the quadratic equation. Okay, students? So today, we'll continue. That is your array of object. Do you remember, in the last class, I told object. That is your class name followed by object. If you create one object, how many instance will create? Yes, only one instance will create. One for data member, one for member function. One for member function. This will be created for only one object. If you want to create multiple instance with a different name, please understand the concept, different name, then you need to create object 1, object 2, like that, n number of objects has to be created. That time your memory will be created for obj1, obj2 will be created for n number of objects. Please recollect your first year knowledge. If I create int a will accept how many value? One value. It may be any value, 10.5. If it is an int, it will take a complete integer number, 10,000, 1 lakh, any number, it will take only one number. If I want to store two values, I need to create two variables. If I want to create a four value, if I want to store six subject marks, then I need to create. Do you remember this? Instead of this, if I want to store 6 subject marks for one particular student, I am using a concept of array. Do you remember? Instead of declaring a 6 different variable, we went with a array. Array with a 6 will allocate how many locations? Continuous 6 locations. Array starts with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Do you remember this concept? Instead of creating A, B, C, D, E, F, That means if you create the variable, you will not get memory allocated continuously in the memory. It takes more time for fetching the data and accessing the data. That we have discussed in the first year itself. If it is only one variable, wherever the memory is free, it will allocate. If you are continuously allocated many variables, wherever the memory is free, in that particular place, the memory will be allocated for those particular variables. It will not allocate continuously. CPU takes more time to store the data and retrieve the data. That is nothing but fetching the data. Storing and retrieving takes more time. That time your CPU takes more time to execute the instructions or your program. If the data is allocated continuously, then CPU time will be reduced so that your programs will be executed very faster. For that method, instead of going with this particular declaration, we are moving for the array. Here also, if you want to create only one object, then go for one object. If you want to store only one instance of the class, go for the one object. If you want to store multiple with a different name, then go for this. If you want to store multiple instance with a single name, then go for array of object. Did you got it? With the same name, multiple instance will be stored. How it will be stored? Obj of, that is object of 0. This will be divided inside into two parts. This is object of 1. This will be allocated like this. N number of whatever you will give, that particular data will be stored. Object of N minus 1. Do you got the student? What is the use of array of object? If you want to store multiple instance of the class with the same object name, then we need array of object. This is a 1 mark question and made possible for 5 marks also. It is array of object. So what is the syntax for that? Class name, object or object name. You need to give the size within the array subscript. This is just one instance, multiple instance with the same name. That is your array of object. And then how you can access this? The same way how we have been done for the earlier, that is your obj dot name. Here obj, that is your object dot class member, right? Class member, this is your either a data member or data member or object dot member function. If you want to access array of object, then here you need to give index. What you need to give? Index object of I. What is that I? I starts with 0 to n minus 1. If you want to store a first instance of the student name and the student number, obj of 0 dot s number, obj of 0 of s name. These two belongs to one instance now. Another instance, it starts with a 1. Another instance, it starts with a 2. If you want to accept like this, then generally what you are going to write? I. I means yes, for loop. I equal to 0. I less than I equal to n. N I plus less than n I plus plus. C in obj of I. You got the student? So these things are enclosed inside the parentheses. Similarly, for the member function also. If you want to accept input data, input data. Similarly for the output data. So this one we have used for one for input, one for output. Invoking, if it is generally a function, then just input and output. Then similarly for the output data also. One more for loop with the output data. That completely I have given in the classwork, complete program. Just go through once. It's a collection of same type of objects are stored in the same name. Understood, student? Thank you. We'll continue in the next class, lab program.